How about that? On the 3G experience. Talking about the blood as we celebrate Palm Sunday this Sunday. Veronica. Good morning, you're on the air.
Good morning, Brother Bill. This is Sister Star.
Good morning, my beloved. How are you?
I'm blessed. How are you?
Great, 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 great.
Good, good. Your mic was open.
I know. I know. It was open on purpose.
Oh, okay. Yes, I am against shots, too.
Okay.
Never had one because I feel like, why should I put a germ into my body and then try to fight another germ? I said, no, I will never. Every time I go to the doctor, they said, you have your flu shot, you had this shot. I said, no, I do not take them. Because I really don't want to get sick. And everyone that I know, even my sister, she had one and made her very sick. So I think maybe sometime the body reacts differently to different people.
Yeah, I'm glad you just said that because you see, as I'm sitting here quiet, I would say the word. Each body, every person's body will react differently to an inoculation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, everybody, you know, we all have enzymes and our bodies are all made the same. We have the same organs, but, you know, we don't all eat the same food. We don't all ingest the same food. Our bodies react differently. Some of it depends on DNA, and then others of it depends on our health habits.
How about little things like high blood pressure or diabetes or things that we're taking medicine for? See, if we're taking medicine for other stuff, then you get an inoculation. There could be some type of interaction. Exactly.
You know, you have to think of it like this. I always go back to the Creator. Mm-hmm. You know, the last time I checked, God hasn't made any mistakes.
Yeah.
So if He made our bodies where, and I bring this up all the time, if you cut yourself and you know with beyond a shadow of a doubt that's going to heal.
Yes.
Sure, it's a pain in the neck, you know, that you know, where it cut yourself.
Right.
But you know, nobody can tell you that.
Without
anything. Without doing anything.
Yeah, it'll heal itself.
It's going to heal. Why is it that all of a sudden our bodies become stupid when it comes to things that are internal?
Yeah.
So whether it's diabetes, whether it's high blood pressure, which, by the way, is not a disease. It's actually an adaptation to an element of toxicity in your body.
And it's a protective medicine.
And it's a protective mechanism. So, you know, that should almost be, wow, my blood pressure is high. Well, gee, let me see what's going on in my body.
Right.
Oh, my cholesterol is high. Okay, well, let me see, you know, instead of taking this, you know, multi-billion dollar cholesterol drug, let me see what I can do for 50 cents, you know, at the drugstore or at a supermarket. Oh, how much is garlic? How much is water? You know, the best blood thinner in the world is water and breathing.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So, seriously, I mean, it sounds odd, but really, that's what it is. So it's really just about going back to the source, going back to whole foods as much as possible, plants. And those, they're life-giving, you know, chlorophyll, you know, spirulina. We're talking about the blood in plants.
Peppermint tea, you know, all that kind of stuff.
You know, things like, you know, healthy fats. Those are the things that are going to give us the life-sustaining, the life-giving force that's going to allow us to fight any disease.
Absolutely.
In the body.
What's going on at Mount Calvary this
week? Well, it's nothing much going on at Mount Calvary. We have an Silent Communion Thursday. Then we had the seven. We having the seven last words Friday morning at 10 o'clock.
And after, oh, you're doing it early.
Yes, we have it early because after then we having fish and chicken sandwiches downstairs. But that's about all right now. Everything has kind of quieted down a little bit.
Yeah, because I mean, everybody and his sisters doing seven last sayings of Christ from the cross.
Yes,
I know that. Anyway, without going through the list, it's there. All right, so I'll know the if I'm out and about early Friday morning, I'll come by and have some fish with y'all.
All right, I'm gonna look forward to you.
Thank you. God bless your heart.
God bless you,
Sister Scott.
Keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you. Good morning. You're on the air. God bless your heart, Sister Ruth. I'm so glad to hear from you. How you doing?
Well, I'm doing fine.
Good.
The only thing I just want to say that I have a problem when I go to the doctor, they want to give me something. They say, I don't understand. You don't have diabetes. You don't have high blood pressure.
Yeah, at 70 plus, you got nothing, none of that.
They say something wrong. Then they got to go get another doctor. They got to get another doctor because they can't believe it. I said, it's God. I told them. But that's what I go through. But anyway, all things due to God.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it's God, and it's also, I'm sure it has something to do with your health habits. Tell me, what's a typical day for you? Do you get enough sunlight? Do you walk around? You know, what do you?
I do. I walk, and I try to do exercise. I try to stay, you know, active. But I can't understand myself because I was in the streets for years.
That's what I was about to say.
Everything, and eating everything, and. My body should be damaged, but it's not.
Watch this. So her history, without going into detail, indicates to me, anyway, that over these years of abuse to her body, it has built up a insulation.
Well, what I wanted to ask was, what I'm gathering is that over the years, this is things that you've done. But I mean, like, are you still eating a lot of sugar, and are you still not taking care of your body?
I try not to be eating all that sugar, and I don't eat sugar at all.
And you're not doing them other things no more.
No.
Right.
Eat a lot of pork. Now I don't be eating that.
Exactly. I mean, you know, the people don't realize, you know, your blood is replenishable. Every 120 days, your blood circulates. So even though back in the days you did that, or maybe some years ago, but if your habits have changed, then obviously your life, your body, your physicality is going to reflect that.
Other calls coming in, my sister. Thank you so much.
Good Talk for you. Soon. Good for you. God bless you.
Stay healthy.
Good for you.
We love you.
All right.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Yes, sir. This is Brother Bill. This is the foot doctor.
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow.
How you doing?
Hi. I just want to say your guest is fabulous, as well as yourself. You guys make a dynamic team for the public and for the listening audience. And I like to contribute something to you and her.
Oh.
One of my clients, his field I've been taking out for the past 30 years, I call him Master Dick. I'd like for her and you to be my guest at his next speaking engagement in Brooklyn on Atlantic Avenue. Altanana, his organization, has him every 6 weeks to come speak to the community. And the next time he comes, which will be within the next 2 or 3 weeks, I want to call you and have you and her come to be my guest to meet, and she don't know Master Dick already, because she's heir to Master Dick's throne. With her knowledge and her love of medicine and health and natural healing, Spirit has told me she's the heir to Master Dick.
Okay. We both know Alton Maddox very well, so it'll be a privilege to be out there with Alton Maddox.
And you both know him, man. I call him Master Dick.
I see.
The world know him as Dick Gregory.
Well, we both know Dick Gregory as well. Again, he's been here, and she's had him in her previous radio activities. So, let me know when he's here, and we'll come out there and see Dick Gregory.
She is heir to his holistic wellness.
Well, I don't know that I would. Well, I'm flattered to even get that association. I mean, you know, Brother Dick Gregory is definitely an icon in the natural health world, and we certainly, I would not put myself in the category of Dick Gregory necessarily, but it's flattering to be compared.
Yeah, thanks
to
for the compliment.
Thank you, brother. Thank you.
All right, don't forget, let me know now. Thank you again.
Yes,
all right.
God bless you, brother
right.
Bill.
God bless your heart. Thank you again. Here on the 3G Experience, ain't no place like this place, so this must be the place.
Yes, very well said.
Right back with more of our sister, Monifa Ma'ad, and you on the phones after this very important message. I feel kind of hungry right now.
Hey, this is Donna, and I want to personally invite you to my restaurant, Home Sweet Harlem. Home Sweet Harlem is a lovely American bistro located at 1528 Amsterdam Avenue between 135th and 136th Streets. You can join us for a good cup of coffee, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Our menu includes heart-healthy foods like a variety of fresh mixed salad greens, grilled garlic shrimp, smoothies, and fresh juices. The amazing St. Nicholas Park turkey burger and the grilled marinated chicken kebabs are among our most popular dishes. Our weekend brunches include a delicious farmer skillet, which is a baked omelet, and it's baked in a cast iron skillet and served with homemade biscuits. We also offer an affordable meeting space for community groups, art shows, and live music. That's Home Sweet Harlem, located at 1528 Amsterdam Avenue between 135th and 136th Streets. You can reach us at 212-926-9616.
And when you go down, I sure hope you do, make sure you tell them, tell Donna that Brother Bill told you to. And those turkey burgers are really, really great because they tell me they catch the turkeys right out here in St. Nicholas.
There is a smile on you. You're joking.
Right out here.
But you know what? Those turkeys might be healthier than the ones confined animal feeding organizations.
That's right, because there's no injections. There's
absolutely
no hormones in there.
Those are the healthiest
and
ones.
The only problem is, though, then they have she has that crock pot type thing she serves with the with the garlic and shrimps and stuff in there. She has some good stuff on the menu, you know. So
I would just go for the turkey. I like what you said about the turkey.
Yeah. And you know,
because it's scary what they're doing to turkeys and chickens these days.
Chickens, yeah. And you know, and we people who look like us eat so much chicken, you know.
We do.
And I'm tired of chicken.
I think that
I'm going to eat me a pork.
Yeah. Well, you know,
there ain't no difference.
Here's the thing.
They're both no good for you in a certain degree, right?
In a sense, in terms of the way that they are confined.
Yeah, and
these
raised.
Feeding organizations and raised, you have a point. I think that if people saw videos of exactly the life of a chicken.
Ugh.
I mean, can you imagine from birth to death.
Standing
standing in an 8.5 by 11 inches. Sheet of paper. Right, inches. So if you know what a piece of paper, 8.5 by 11
yeah,
looks like,
sheet of paper, yeah.
That's about the diameter, okay? That's about the space of a chicken.
Right.
You know, and there are thousands of them. Thousands.
And they'll just stand there.
And they just stand in their own, exactly. I mean, they actually have to cut the... See, I don't want to give just the bad news, but I mean, I do believe in just being realistic. You know, they have to
cut their beaks
off
so they don't
to keep them
each
from,
other.
You know, going crazy and attacking each other.
Yeah, and then some of them are injected.
Yeah,
that's where you get large chicken breasts
from. Hormones, antibiotics. I mean, it used to be that you just kind of had to wait for them to grow, but now it's like just the level of impatience, you know, due to profit.
And they even have fish ponds, you know, like that tilapia. They
sure.
grow, that's a man-made fish, farm fish, you know.
Unfortunately, fish is not today what it used to be
right.
30, 50 years
right.
ago. I mean, I'm a lover of fish.
I go fishing.
But I don't.
You know, I fish, you know.
Yeah.
It's just the cotton fishes, too, you know. You know, it's scary.
The waters are unfortunately, our waterways are polluted.
And I see the men over here on the Hudson River, over there by the pollution plant, fishing.
But people might say, well, what if I like fish? What can I do? This is what I would say. The internet, in this case, is your best friend. Sometimes it's just best to just order your fish, you know, from a company that...
Is that expensive?
Well, not as expensive as you might think. Okay. I would say, you know, wild Alaskan. I'm told that, you know, the word Alaska, you know, is probably, there's more than likely the fish are not going to be farmed, because I don't think that you could put the word Alaska, you know, like say Alaska, if it's really not from Alaska.
Yeah.
But wild is the key word, Alaskan salmon. Just Google it, because if you think about it, yes, you know, salmon has been known to $25, $30 a pound. But if you're having it once a month, think about it. Yeah. Or if you buy the salmon and make, as my mother does at times, you know, a salmon stew. It doesn't have to be just, you know, you have a big piece of salmon on the side of your plate with a salad. You can make a soup. You can make a stew. Make it last.
Well, I have the cans of salmon at home, mm-hmm. and I make salmon croquettes and salmon patties, mm-hmm. you know, but I probably make them very unhealthy.
Well, try to make sure that it's wild. So make sure that on the can it says wild Alaskan.
That it does. Now that I mentioned it, it does say that.
Right, because the key is, you know, we think, well, this is expensive. This is expensive. But, you know, medication and doctor bills is also expensive.
But you got coverage for that, though.
Coverage,
Which is a whole other segment, the program.
Coverage. It still doesn't cover it.
I know it doesn't.
Right, because
you got a copay.
Right.
And I had, in sense of disclosure, I have, and also I have a that I pay for every mm-hmm. month, right? And I had to get a particular medicine, and my copay was $157. Mm-hmm. And I said, oh, no, this can't, because I got this and I got that and I got that. No, you have a deductible in your health plan.
Right, but somebody has to pay for it. See, it's not just what...
They wrote another prescription for a tier one or a tier two drug that does the same thing. Mm-hmm. That ended up being $10.
Right, but the bottom line is the government. You know, somebody has to pay.
So the thing is,
do we want to, you know, just manage the disease and spend billions of dollars, or do we really want to care for our bodies and prevent the disease in the first place? That's the key.
Okay, right back with Sister Monifa Ma'at after this music.
Come on, we're taking it back. We're singing praises to our King, for He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. Somebody make some noise in this place. We come to bless His name. Put your hands together. Hallelujah. Come on, we sing praises.
Sing praises to our King.
Forevermore.
Come on, make it personal. He reigns.
He reigns.
Somebody say He reigns. He reigns forever. Yes, He does. Come on, all the believers, declare it unto Him. Lift Him on high forevermore. Come on, He reigns. Yes, He does. We bless You, Jesus. There's nobody like You. Come on, all hail. Come on and give Him glory in this place. Come on, I need some signs, 93 believers.
Every praise
is to our God. Let's take it up one more time. Every praise
Hezekiah Walker. Every praise is to our God. I sure hope that what's his name? David? I forgot his name. David, somebody wrote that song. I sure hope he did the proper paperwork.
Yeah.
Because Hezekiah has made a whole lot of money off that song around the world. They're playing this. I got good morning. Oh, God. I just blew that.
call us back.
Wow. Over in Europe, okay? She's going to shoot. I know they're going to hate me. Our sister Sylvia, they're listening over in Bulgaria somewhere right now. I don't know what time it is over there, but they're listening right now.
Okay.
And they play this over there, you know. And they even sent me a CD of their music, which I play occasionally.
You know, even at my church, Mother Amy Zion, we get visitors from all over the country. They love the music.
They do. You know, I'm going to put a compilation disc together just for them. Just for the Turistas.
Well, you'll definitely make sure you get all your licensing and everything.
Yeah. Listen, let's go into food. I want to talk about foods that are good for us and foods that we should have in our freezer and our refrigerator, and then how long should we keep certain things? I've got some ground beef in my freezer, and I don't even know how long it's been there, but I was being generous and I was offering it to here. Have some ground beef. They said, "This ain't no good." I said, but it's frozen. So tell me about that. Right. You know, I mean,
you know, I'm not a, I actually wouldn't even remember very much what beef tastes like.
I know.
Because I don't. But in terms of, you know, and this goes back to that whole nutritionist thing.
Longevity.
You know,
how long can you keep something certain?
I can. Well, let's talk about the foods that are healthy to have in the refrigerator. It's one of my favorite topics.
Okay.
And so I want to stay on point with talking about, we talk about what we shouldn't have and things that we can't eat. And that's, you know, important. But I think what's more interesting and what's more craveable, that's my word, you know, you want to get people to crave health. You want to get people to wake up in the morning and think about this.
Somebody else
crave.
Uses what that terminology, I crave.
Yeah. I'm really loving that word. I actually wrote a play called Crave.
Oh yeah,
that's another story.
There's a female fraternal organization that uses that terminology.
Craving is all about, you know, something that you gotta have. So isn't it wonderful if it's something that is health oriented?
White Castle even says crave.
Yeah, so that you don't want to. Well, anyway, but you want to crave things that are healthful. So. Let's talk about that. So here are my top 10 foods that should be absolutely craveable. And if they're not, make them craveable in your life because they will add not only years to your life, but they'll make you feel good. They taste amazing and they'll just spice up your diet and your nutrition. So number one, dark green leafy vegetables.
Dark,
I'm talking
green, leafy,
kale,
like what?
Like kale, spinach. You can do mustard greens. You could do Swiss chard. You could do cabbage, red leaf lettuce.
I like Brussels sprouts.
Brussels sprouts are absolutely awesome. They have a rich nutty flavor. You can roast them.
With garlic and
you can steam them. Garlic and
but then
olive
I, then,
oil.
Then in your eyes, olive oil. I killed them though. I used butter and garlic.
Oh well, you know, well as long as that butter is organic and it comes from a cow. Oh, you're shaking your head. No. Okay. Well, you know, as long as it's organic, it comes from a source that is not filled with, you know, hormones and antibiotics. Butter is actually, in moderation, not a bad saturated
fat. That's what I was going to say, in moderation.
But in any case, of course, you know, olive oil, coconut oil is better. But, and that's what I would recommend. But dark green leafy vegetables. Let me tell you why, though, and then I want to hear your question.
Uh-huh.
Dark green leafy vegetables. Why? Because that's where you're going to get your calcium from. A lot of people think that you could just get your calcium from milk.
Yeah.
And dairy products, and that is the biggest misconception in the world. Your calcium comes from green, dark green leafy vegetables. Mm-hmm. It's also is a detoxifier to your body. Helps to alkalize it and just kind of get rid of all the acid that we eat that comes from sugars and undigested foods that we eat. So I would highly recommend dark green leafy vegetables. You can eat them whole. You can juice them. You can steam them. You can saute them. But just make sure that it's something that you keep on hand.
The same cauliflower.
All of those cruciferous vegetables.
I like that.
Cauliflower. You know what's really good? Cauliflower and broccoli roasted.
Almost
with a
like
little olive oil.
In a winter vegetable type thing.
Yeah, but it's great in the spring broccoli. As well. Sure, you can maybe steam it and then cool it.
See, I kill it with
put
garlic.
It in a salad.
And, I kill it with garlic and butter.
Yeah, but try olive oil. Try olive oil.
Okay.
Yeah, it's... It's a healthier fat, and it's really good for your internally for your organs. Now, next, number two would be avocado. Now, these are things that you want to make sure are consistently on your grocery shopping list. And there's also what I'm going to talk about this Friday when we have our second grocery shopping tour. Yeah, that's coming up tomorrow at 5 p.m. in Harlem.
And that's on Lenox Avenue.
It is, on 129th Street at the Pioneer Supermarket.
Yes.
So
I made note of that.
I've talked to the manager, and I've kind of, wink, I've kind of trying to twist their arm to put certain items on sale.
Or in front, especially.
Absolutely, and to put them on
cap.
Sale.
Yes. Yeah.
And
I got to remind Steve Lynn, because he wanted to come down with some of the men.
Last time we went, they gave us the, we got a deeper discount than the firemen's. Can I say that?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, we got a 10% discount. So thank you, Pioneer Supermarket. And so we're going to do it again tomorrow at 5 p.m. at West 129th Street and Lenox Avenues, but we're going to meet first at Emblem Neighborhood Care, which is at 215 West 125th Street. That's going to be at 4:30, just to do a check-in and attendance and that sort of thing, just to make sure we have everybody together.
Now, Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm sure people are looking for more information. So
I'm sending a note to Steve now. You're going to be at the Name and Walk It again?
Yeah, Pioneer. Supermarket on West 129th Street and Lenox Avenue. We're going to be there at 5 p.m., but we're going to meet first at Emblem Neighborhood Care, Emblem Health Neighborhood Care at 215 West 125th Street.
For shopping tips.
At 4:30 p.m. And for more information, people can call 347-903-0637.
It's radio. Say it again.
347-903-0637. 347-903-0637.
Good. I just texted Steve because he wanted to come down with some of the fathers.
That would be terrific. That would be great. Yeah. The only thing is, you know, it was a good thing we were really nice about it. Last time we were blocking the aisles just a little bit because there was a few more people that showed up than we anticipated.
Oh, really?
But it was great. It was fun. You know, it was really a lot of fun, and I think we all learned a lot. It was really cold that day.
All right, so we got down to
dark greens. Number two, avocado.
I love that, too.
Oh, my goodness.
It has no taste, but it does.
You know, it really does. That's the beauty of it. That's the beauty of it, you know, because you can spice it up. You can make guacamole with it. And it's also a substitute for things like mayonnaise and mustard and ketchup.
Oh, yeah?
Because you can use it as a condiment. Absolutely. You know, the other day, I was making eggs, and I wanted to put it on a piece of whole grain bread, and I just had the taste for something like a mayo taste, but I don't really use mayonnaise much. So what I did was I took thin slices of avocado, and I used that for my mayonnaise and put my eggs on top of that, and it was just absolutely divine.
No cheese.
And then I mixed in some Swiss chard, believe it or not. I know
See,
it sounds crazy.
I knew you had to have some cheese in there.
No, Swiss chard.
What's that?
That's a dark green leafy vegetable.
Oh, okay.
Right?
I thought you said Swiss, like Swiss cheese.
Although, you know, cheese is not a horrible.
In moderation.
But I would highly recommend if you do it in moderation, make sure that it's organic. Because you have to remember, you're not just eating the cheese, you're eating what the cow ate. Okay? All right? So that's important. So avocado. And you can spice it up, you can spice it down. So keep those on hand. And it's such a great healthy fat. It's got plenty of vitamin E, And
what can you do with red peppers or hot sauce?
Oh, my goodness, red peppers. So you're talking about the kind that you slice. Red peppers are really great if you have a food processor. You could actually put red pepper. I actually have a recipe for salad dressing utilizing red peppers that I saw just the other day. There was a gentleman on YouTube, and his name escapes me right now, but he's also a health professional. And I can just tell you that he made this salad dressing that looks so good. I mean, I'm watching it, and I could almost taste it when I was watching it. But he used garlic, orange juice, red pepper, sea salt, avocado, which
I'm
is what I just mentioned.
I'm seeing a lot of that sea salt lately.
Yeah, sea salt. Well, we talked about that. Well, let me finish.
I'm sorry. Because
I know
so
people
much...
are listening, and, yeah. and they may be writing, and they're like, wait a minute, Brother Bill, hold on. Let me just get the rest of the recipe. So it's, starting again, it's garlic, 4 cloves of garlic. He says 16 ounces of orange juice. It was about maybe 2 red peppers cut up. Then 1 avocado cut up. Cayenne pepper, maybe about 2 teaspoons or so, powdered or fresh ginger. So it depends on what you have on hand. I use both powdered or fresh ginger. Turmeric, you can use the powdered or you can actually use the actual turmeric you get from the grocery store. It kind of reminds you of a supermarket. Reminds you of, what is that herb? Ginger. It kind of looks like that. It's a root. And some black cumin seed oil, which you could find in a health food store. But if you can't find black cumin seed oil, I say just use olive oil, okay? Cold press olive oil. You put all that in the food processor or blender, and you've got what I saw to be something I haven't even had a chance to try yet because I just saw this recipe yesterday. But since you mentioned red peppers, that's a great salad dressing recipe.
How about hot pepper? To hot shake pepper. Out. You know,
red. You can. Those go great in any.
See, I'm thinking because what I've done, admittedly, is I've cut back on my salt intake. Okay. And instead of salt, I'll use other stuff like the red peppers, a little more garlic, perhaps. You know,
ginger.
I haven't done that. I will try that.
But, tastes delicious.
Yeah.
On vegetables. Yeah, a little powdered ginger.
Oh, powdered ginger.
It almost takes the place of salt.
Okay.
It adds a taste that. It kind of steers you away from that salty flavor that you're expecting and gives you this unexpected, really rootsy, deep sort of flavor with lots of nuances, the ginger, sort of like a nutty, really special flavor. It adds a special flavor to vegetables.
Where are you on your list?
So we're at only at number 2. So I'm just going to do 5. So number 3 item to have on hand in your kitchen are lemons. Lemons, one of the most versatile.
Do lemons have to stay in the refrigerator?
Not necessarily. If you know you're going to use them within maybe 3 days or so, I would just leave them out. But if you know that you've bought maybe 10 or 12 lemons, absolutely put them in the crisper. Put them in the refrigerator. They'll keep longer. But sometimes if I know I'm going to use them in that day or maybe in the next day or two, I'll just leave them out in a fruit bowl.
What about that plant that grows about the onion? Is
scallion?
No, the sure enough onion. After a while, it grows.
That's on the list.
It grows into there's a plant that grows about the onion. Is that?
Well, you know, you mentioned onions and garlic. I have them both together.
Good.
On the list. Keep those on hand. Onions and garlic are basically nature's pharmacy. So, you know, when you think about, oh, I have to go to the pharmacy, go look no further than your refrigerator, okay? Garlic is a natural, we all know this now, garlic is a natural medicinal antibiotic. It is, and especially crushed garlic, not just the whole cloves. The whole cloves, right, but you want to crush them if you utilize them in your food
and
because
the red
it releases
onions,
something called allicin.
And the red onion is good for high blood pressure.
Yeah, red onions are good, really, really good. All onions, but red onions, so I've heard. Great for high blood pressure. And also, it also has medicinal qualities when put together. So you can add that to your eggs. You can add that to your stews, to your soups, to your meats as a stir fry. I mean, it's just something that you just always want to have on hand, get your veggies on.
There's somebody blinking their headlights at Grand Concourse and 161st Street. And I've asked that if anybody is out and about in their vehicle listening to WHCR, And I've got certain intersections that I'm monitoring here now, Grand Concourse and 161st Street. And it just caught my eye, so I just caught blinking the head. What the hell wrong with him? Then I realized I'd asked people about half hour ago,
yeah,
if you're in the car and you're listening, blink your headlights. He may have heard me down at another vantage point, and now I'm looking at 149th and Grand Concourse, and he's gone.
Blink again.
No, he was up 61st Street. He's gone now. Maybe that was Judge Kennedy. Anyway, 149th Street and River Avenue I'm looking at now. And I'm looking south from 149th Street. That means that as you're coming off the Major Deegan Expressway, I'm looking at you. 7th Avenue, 145th Street is in my view. And then I see Lincoln Hospital over there, and then the Hess gas station. I'm looking east on 145th Street. So if you're out there coming across 145th Street, I see you, and blink your headlights. Let me know you're out there. I'm sorry. I just caught that light blinking in my eye.
Very cool. So definitely blink if you're listening to WHCR, the 3G Experience.
Especially. 9.3 FM. So you're right. Now, going back to that list there.
Well, you know, next on the list is quinoa.
Who?
And quinoa. And that's the response that I get from, you know, a lot of my clients. But it's becoming more popular now. A lot of people are beginning to understand and know the benefits of quinoa.
I bite the bait. What is it?
It's a wonderful grain, but it depends on who you talk to. It's a grain, it's a seed. But the bottom line is it's a healthful protein. It's got vitamins, nutrients, protein. It's a substitute for rice. It's a better way to explain it. So if you know what rice is, quinoa can be prepared in the same way that you would prepare couscous or rice. Kind of looks like a cross between the two, actually. And it has a delicious sort of nutty flavor. The same thing that you would do with a rice, whether you add beans, whether you add it as a side dish, you know, to a chicken, or whether you even have it in a salad, you can use quinoa.
I just read on Facebook, and we're going to take a break, about eating cold rice rather than hot rice. You up on that yet?
Cold rice. What did you read about it?
White rice, that cold white rice is just as good or nutritious, if there's any nutrition at all, as eating it heated.
Listen, think of the most, I hate to say this, but think of the most disgusting thing that you can think of to eat right now, and then just picture it cold.
Can't.
It doesn't make any sense.
Not at all.
You know,
we'll be
white
right
rice is, it will raise your glycemic index.
Oh,
it turns
want
to
do
sugar
that.
And
that's
and
right.
And sugar and in the body.
And of course, yeah, on
whether
top
it's
of
hot,
that,
cold, lukewarm.
Yeah, and
or
the
whatever.
Brain metabolizes sugar, which means that eating certain things, rice included, at certain times of the day or night could affect your not being able to sleep at
night.
Well,
it's interesting you said the brain metabolizes sugar, because when we think about the digestive system, when you think about the gut, the uh-huh. gut is the second brain.
Yeah.
You know, you forget that there are many nerves, something like 90% of nerves that are connected to the central nervous system in the brain are connected to your digestive system. So when you hear things like, you know, leaky gut and IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, a lot of that comes from, you know, ingesting foods that could possibly irritate the lining of the stomach. And so what happens is some of those undigested particles can actually leak into the blood and then sift their way up to
problems.
The brain.
Yeah, yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
So it's the second brain.
All right, right back with some
brain.
More hot food tips. I mean, not just hot as in temperature. I mean, hot as far as importance. Right here on your favorite radio station.
Don't touch that dial. Keep it locked on WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem.
Here on the 3G Experience, the gift, the grace, and the glory. The weather outside was supposed to be raining, but it's not from what I can see here. But still. Got one more time to try it, son, and I'm not going to let you sing. No, really, because I take it personally, you know, because some of these people, you know, they really think that they got it like that, so they're not going to sing for me. So fine, don't sing for me. I'll click on down here to somebody else. ain't no thing, right? On the 3G experience. Always keep something in the changer. 3G experience, the gift, the grace, and the glory. Brother Bill here doing a thing for nobody but you. Come on. New Orleans, yeah, a lot of energy. that was live in New Orleans with Oscar Hayes and the Abundant Life Fellowship Choir. Say that three times fast.
Abundant Life Fellowship Choir. Abundant Life Fellowship Choir. Did you say five times?
Listen, yeah, only because you're a well-trained broadcast specialist yourself. Other than that, we ask people, don't try this at home. You see, leave it. You know, we have thick tongues and fat lips, and it's kind of difficult to say certain things, you see. Listen, how about this? What are some, listen, to you people out there, what is some of your favorite unhealthy food that you eat? What do you, and let's just leave fried chicken off the list.
I was wondering how you're going to deal with that one.
No.
How I was going to deal with that one.
No fried chicken. We don't discuss, because we know it ain't no good for you. In fact, I was in Kentucky Fried. I want to Kentucky. Listen at this.
Tell on yourself.
Yeah.
Tell it.
I went to Kentucky Fried last night, and the crew that I was with just had a taste for chicken wings. So we went to Kentucky Fried Chicken, and you know that at 100, and I'm putting it out here like that too, 18 minutes past the hour, 145th Street and Malcolm X Boulevard, Lenox Avenue, KFC.
I know where it is.
Ain't had no chicken wings.
They had no chicken wings.
And I asked them, I said, how can you have a chicken place in Harlem and don't have no chicken wings at 6:30 in the evening? What's the way? We didn't get our delivery. You should have went across the street and caught some. I mean, come on.
Right, the chicken coop, you know, that Sister Donna uses.
But anyway, so listen.
Yeah, I'll deal with fried chicken.
Okay, so the phones are open, 212-650-6903. And let's hear what you eat that you know is no good for you, and our sister Monifa is going to give you a alternative to that. Let's see what we got. Good morning, you're on the air.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I know you need to get to turn your radio down or land your spaceship or something, because you sound like you're go ahead, talk to me.
I am just surprised that I got on the air. Thank you. To the brother, it's clear that you're not into health foods, but the sister is giving some very important information, and can you please let her continue when she starts?
So what do you eat that's not healthy?
Well, actually, there's nothing that I eat that's not healthy. I am, the five things that she gave a while ago, those are five of my favorite foods.
Oh,
that's why I appreciate her, what she said. It's very informative.
Oh, well, thank you, sister. And what do you like to do? What is dark green leafy vegetables, avocado, quinoa? What are one of your favorite recipes?
I don't actually do the recipes thing.
Okay. You just use them. You keep them in your kitchen. You have them on hand.
I love quinoa. And I may do that. And I used to do tofu, but I don't anymore.
Oh, that's a good thing. That's a good thing.
Yeah, I did some research on it, and I don't think it will help my health. So I don't do that anymore. But I saute greens and may do some quinoa. And avocado is just amazing. I love
avocado.
Isn't
it? There's so many things you could do with it.
Yes, and olive oil. I love coconut oil. Coconut oil is just awesome.
What do you do with your coconut oil? Do you ingest it? You use it for your skin, your hair? What do you do?
Yeah, well, actually, as you can hear my accent, I am from the Caribbean.
Of course, darling.
I grew up where we were using the coconut milk.
Yes.
And we're cooking rice, putting it in soups. With the what they call turmeric, now we call curry.
Okay.
So we would mix that in but using it, my hair was locked before. When I was 12, my hair was locked. I had people calling me buckwheat and everything else. Now everyone is locked, but I'm a trailblazer when it comes to dreadlocks.
Yes. I bet they're beautiful, too, because coconut oil is really good for the hair.
Oh, yeah, and for the skin. And right now they're using it to brush their teeth. People are brushing their teeth.
Yeah, it's called tooth pulling. It's called tooth pulling. It's because it pulls out all the toxins.
Yes, for the gums and whatnot.
Sure.
So
whitens the teeth.
Yes, plus I love beans. I use a lot of lentils. I love kidney beans and stuff.
Yeah. Well, but thank you, sister.
For me, the problem I'm having here health-wise is that my blood pressure is always seem to be up. In spite of what I eat, I spend thousands monthly at Whole Foods and all these other places. And I refuse to take the medication. I'm afraid of it. I'm a veteran, so they quickly send you a lot of medication all
sure.
in the mail. You're getting, and I'm not good with meds.
Sister, I would say to you just very quickly, because I don't know your background, but I would say three things. One, exercise. Two, breathing, meditation.
Yeah.
All right? Breathing is extremely important. Three, watch your posture, how you're sitting. If you sit a lot, if your posture, if your shoulders are rounded over, you can try a quick experiment right now. Round your shoulders over, kind of bend your head down, and take a deep breath. Just try it. Then, after you do that, try now lifting your shoulders, or rather retracting your shoulders back, opening up the chest, lifting the chin so that you're facing straight ahead, and now take a deep breath. Do you find that your breath, you can take in more oxygen?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? So better circulation, something just that simple. So I would definitely, it's, sometimes the simplest thing is the most profound. Exercise, yeah. Breathing, meditation, and watch your posture.
And thank you for listening, and certainly call again, my sister. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Good morning. You're on the air.
The Lord is my shepherd, Brother Bill. Good morning to you and your guests.
Good morning.
I'm going to go what I call in the deep darkness. I want to have you to explain the benefits of this food group: sardines, herrings, mackerel, asparagus, and you already got into the scallions. I want you and peanut butter. I want you to try and, you know, if you can, just whatever part. I'll break down the benefits of that particular food group.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Are those foods that you eat a lot of? Is that why you?
No, those are the foods that I grew up on.
Okay. Okay.
And I'm 72 years old, looking like I would say a spring chicken.
Looking like 90.
Yeah. Oh. Right, that's Brother interesting. Bill. Now you said sardines, mackerel, asparagus, and what was the other one?
You can go with broccoli, but I really wanted you to initiate the fish group.
Okay.
All right, the herring, the mackerel, and the sardines.
Okay.
And then the asparagus, broccoli, and peanut butter, of course.
Well, you know what? I can tell you that a lot of the foods that you just mentioned, what they have in common is healthy fats. So particularly if you're talking about sardines and peanut butter, I think there was another healthy fat in there that you mentioned, mackerel,
yes.
Healthy fats. I eat sardines myself. That's why I smile, because sardines are one of my favorite fish now, because so many of our fish are being polluted, you know, by the waters. They contain BPAs and mercury and things like that. So they're just not really that healthy. But if you talk about some of the smaller fish, cold water fish like sardines, they're not as affected by those things. Right, as the larger fish. So that could be why you're 72, probably looking 42 or 52, because
you're going to buy into that, right?
And if you look at many of the people in, like, Alaska and so forth, you know, where there's fish are plentiful and they, you know, eat a lot of the cold water fish, they also, for what I understand, have lower levels of high blood pressure than we do here in North America. You know, here in the United States. So, eating the cold water fish, the small fish like sardines, healthy fats, make sure that they're in olive oil and that they're not smoked, because you don't know what that smoke is. You don't know what they're using to, I don't know if they're using wood chips to smoke it, but a lot of that smoke flavor. And when you talk about flavor and natural flavors, then that's synonymous with MSG, monosodium glutamate. So I would just say just plain, you know, on the ingredients, check the ingredients of your sardines and make sure it just says sardines in olive oil or sardines in water, spring water, not even in soybean oil, just, you know, olive oil or water. Very, very important. Very versatile. You could use them on a sandwich. You can put some organic corn grits, you know, to the side, and fishing grits. So there's a lot you can do with it. You can put them on a cracker. I'm not sure how you eat them, but they're very versatile, very delicious, very filling, lots of protein, lots of healthy fat. Of course, the asparagus and the broccoli, green vegetables, just definitely great for your system. They serve as an internal broom for your intestines to sweep out a lot of the, you know, lots of fiber, so to sweep out a lot of the toxins and to aid in elimination. So you're always going to win with vegetables. The wonderful thing about vegetables is that they do contain a lot of fiber, which is very filling. You can have as much of it as you want. Try to make sure that if you're eating the vegetables, though, particularly the ones that you eat the most of, that you try your best to get them organic, particularly if they're leafy, like a kale. You didn't mention kale, but I mean, just for anyone's list, kale, spinach.
Peanut butter, rough on the system, rough on the belly, especially for older people. Very rough on the stomach.
What did you say was rough on the stomach? I didn't hear you. I'm sorry.
The kale and the Brussels sprouts.
You can juice it.
You're rough on the stomach.
You can juice it. So there's different ways you can prepare the green leafies, right? So if you find it's a little rough, juice it, or you can cut it really fine, very 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 fine.
You have done justice.
Right. And then you can add that to, you know, to your sandwiches. So it sounds like you're doing all the right things. And the thing that it sounds like is that you're not just eating these things because it's healthy. You're eating it because you truly enjoy it. You like it. It's something that you grew up on. And unfortunately, a lot of us, particularly if you're, let's say, 35 and older or whatever, grew up on some of the comfort foods like the white rice and the white bread, you know, Wonder Bread, the white bread products.
Every meal got to have rice.
Right. And that's not, you know, necessarily the most healthful thing. So the key is to find those things, those foods. Here's the key to health. Find those foods that you truly enjoy and find a way to make it healthy. Does that make sense? Find a way to enjoy it, to love it. Like you said, the kale is hard on your system. Well, juice it. Add a little green apple to it. Add a little, maybe a little carrot, a little bit of parsley, a little bit of ginger to that. I mean, if you have to, you want to make it sweet, put a little tiny, tiny bit of raw honey in there. Maybe an avocado. Juice that up, and you have a delicious drink.
Peanut butter. He mentioned peanut butter.
Peanut butter is really good. I would highly recommend to get your peanut butter from a place like Whole Foods or even Trader Joe's, a place that's organic. You want organic peanuts because peanuts have been associated.
Skippy.
I'm not going to hate on any brand, but I will say this.
Skippy.
Organic. Organic. You know, or make it yourself. I think it's Whole Foods. There's another store, and I will get back to you on that, that you can actually make your own peanut butter. You know, you put the peanut butter, peanuts in, the grinder, and you grind out your own
Brother
peanuts.
Smiley, thank you so much for that. You've pulled off the scab here because I like peanut butter myself. Skippy.
Many of the peanut, you know, planting process, you know, it's, again, we're dealing with herbicides and pesticides and things like that. So you want to be careful with that.
Right back with more healthy food stuff from our sister, Monifa Ma'at. Stand by. Don't you dare go nowhere. Ronnie Dyson. As we glitter in the glow of golden goodness here on the 3G Experience. Song written by Leon Russell. Reinterpreted by our own Edgar Kendricks, but here's the one I like. Brooklyn Born. Listen and think about it.
I've been so many places in my life and time. You know, I've sung a lot of songs. I've even made some bad rhymes. I've acted out my life on stages, oh yeah, with 10,000 people watching, yeah. But we're alone now, right now. And I'm singing my song for you. You, I know your image of me is something that I've tried to be. I've treated you unkindly, yeah. But oh, can't you see, can't you see, there's no one more important to me. Oh no, honey, can't you believe, see through me, 'cause we're alone now, right now. And I'm singing my song for you. And oh, you taught me precious secrets, yeah, of a truth with a holding nothing. Your love came right out in front, and I was sort of hiding, yeah, yeah. But right now, now I'm so much better. Oh yes I am. And in my together, no. Listen, listen to the melody. Because my love is in the air, in the heart. Yeah, yeah. I love you in a place where there was no space or time. I loved you for all the reasons. You were a mighty good friend of mine, yes you were. But when my life is over, all over, will you remember when we were together, yeah? 'Cause we're alone now, right now. And I'm singing my song, singing it for you.
Ronnie Dyson, a song for you here on the 3G Experience. When is your thing tomorrow at Pioneer? Tell us.
Sure. So it's called Shop Healthy and Save, and it's not just saving your money, saving your life, right?
Ooh.
Oh yes.
That's
Shop
deep.
Healthy and Save.
Yeah.
And
save
so
your life.
This is our part two. Mm-hmm. Part
How'd two. The first one go? You said it was overcrowded. The store was full of people there for your effort. Not so much regular shopping folk.
Well, there were regular shopping folk there, but, you know, it was a nice little group. It was about nine of us. And so that's a lot, you know, blocking. It was a healthful, really fun blocking of the aisles. And so, you know, we caused a little stir, but it was great. Everybody loved us. And, you know, a couple wanted to actually join the tour. So it was really, really nice. It was great. So we're going to be at Emblem Health Neighborhood Care at 215 West 125th Street. And that is going to be Friday. That's tomorrow at 4:30 p.m. We're going to do our check-in, and then we're going to march on over to Pioneer. If you want to meet us at Pioneer, That's fine too at 5 o'clock, but it's best that you meet, that we meet, because this way I can register everybody at 4:30. Because after a while, you know, the tour can't be too large because we can't have like, you know, 20, 30 people there. So we really want to register people at Emblem. The first people to register, 4:30 p.m., 215 West 125th Street, 4:30 p.m. on Friday. And then we'll walk over to Pioneer on 129th Street.
Coach Stephen Lynn is listening. Good morning, Coach. He's going to be there tomorrow as
Fantastic.
Well. Because, you know, he just recently did a thing on Facebook. In the supermarket where he teaches the men, the fathers,
yes.
teaches them how to shop.
Oh, my goodness. It'd be great if some of the fathers, Coach Steve, if you can bring some of the fathers as well. And it's such a healthful experience. And I want people to know, and it's something that I also mentioned in my book, that we have more power than we realize. It's not enough to just say, well, I went to the store and they didn't have it. They didn't have the organic bacon or they didn't have the, you know, which, by the way, is Applegate Farms makes a really good organic turkey bacon. But or they didn't have the organic eggs. So they didn't have.
Can we get them as a sponsor?
What we can do. Well, let's hope so. Okay, that's another conversation.
Yeah.
We will revisit that because I know you're doing fundraising.
Yeah.
But it's, we have more power because the thing is that if they don't have it, then you talk to the manager and you let them know,
sure,
this is what I want.
Sure.
And they will investigate.
Yeah, and
it's what I
it.
Did. And I'm not saying anything that I didn't do myself.
Yeah.
I mean, my own supermarket in my neighborhood has changed dramatically. I'm certainly not going to take the credit, all of the credit for that. But I can tell you this.
No, because you ain't Pakistani.
The managers.
You ain't Pakistani.
Well, let me just say this. My supermarket, which happens to be Food Town, actually sponsored several of my fitness camps.
Yeah.
So that's the kind of relationship that we've built up. So that's what I'm going to say to that. And it's just a matter of beating that drum, constantly beating that drum. It doesn't take 50,000 people. Sometimes
and I
it
think
just
the
takes
important
one.
Thing is that you remind your store owners, especially as neighborhoods change.
Mm.
Certain neighborhoods in our listening audience, they're bringing their healthy eating habits with them from elsewhere.
There you go.
See, so therefore, it's in the store owner's best interest to start carrying these things that you speak of. Give me something else off that list.
Sure. So another one of my favorite superfoods. And it's interesting, I don't eat as much of them as I used to. I think also it's important to buy organic, but I would say bananas. They are full of minerals, potassium.
Oh, it's in potassium.
And they're filling. I like to look at them as nature's candy.
Yeah.
They're versatile. You can put them in a smoothie. The other day I actually had banana bread, and how I had it was I just took a half of a banana because, again, it's not necessary that you eat the whole banana, okay, at that time, particularly if you
What do you do with the rest of it?
You put it in the refrigerator until you're ready for the second half.
It's going to turn brown.
No, not really. You cut it. The secret is you just use a knife, a sharp knife, and you just cut it in half. And it usually keeps for days. It can keep for days in the refrigerator. And when you're ready for it, you just cut off the little, you know, the tip of it. But so what I took the banana bread and I sliced it. Excuse me, the banana, and I sliced it, and I put it in a slice of whole grain bread, and I sprinkled cinnamon on it, and that was, can I just say, that was the most delicious banana, quote-unquote, bread that I have ever eaten.
Banana sandwich.
Yes, but it was really, really good. So that was a way that, because it was filling, it was quick, and then I was off, you know.
My father used to eat bananas. He used to always carry two bananas with him, as I think back now, and bananas, you know. And he always had one in the car. So that during the course of the day, if he felt hungry or wanted to eat something, he'd eat a banana rather than stop and get some ribs.
A candy bar.
Or some chicken. Or some whatever. Right. Food. You know, he'd wait until he got home that night to eat food.
Yep.
You know, so yeah. I see. It goes full circle. Okay.
Bananas is another one. Uh-huh. And a girlfriend of mine, actually, now we've all heard of, you know, berries are really our nature's, again, pharmacy. When you want to think about the pharmaceutical industry, think of Mother Nature. Think of garlic, onions, and berries. Berries are so good. Fresh is better. And, of course, I'm going to beat that drum and say organic is better, particularly for berries like strawberries, blueberries, you know, sort of goji berries. I mean, whatever berries that you happen, blackberries, to eat. They're really good for your system. They're antioxidants, meaning that they keep the oxidation levels low in your body. And we know that oxidation is, you know, synonymous with disease. Mm-hmm. And they taste delightful. And we all know that, you know, in a smoothie, in a yogurt. They're just
delicious.
How
about wild berries that grow in the trees, like in parks, in local parks like that? You see berries, the little red berries growing up.
Right.
Can you eat them?
I would definitely get a book in the library or go online and research wild berries. No, certainly not here.
Okay.
I would not suggest that.
Okay.
I would suggest going to your local supermarket and buying organic. Yes,
blueberries.
Because you know
I
you
like
don't
blueberries.
Know. Blueberries are good. Blueberries are great for your. They have lutein, so it's really good for your eyes. Lutein.
What's that?
It's a substance called lutein.
What's it do?
It's an antioxidant. It's really good for your eyes, for eyesight.
Oh, I need that.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Oh. We've learned a lot this morning, gang. Yes. And that's why I'm just so glad to have her here with us. And she'll be back on the third Thursday, which is the, let me go here now, I'm sorry.
And we're also going to talk about recipe ideas.
Yeah, quickly, do that, because it's 42
tomorrow
minutes.
Tomorrow as well. So during the shopping trip, we'll talk about recipe ideas. I just gave you one for bananas.
Uh-huh.
It's really about being versatile with your food. Play with your food, really important. Spices are also important. You know, we can make it a point, you know, every week or every 2 weeks, I'm going to learn something new about a new spice.
Like cinnamon, nutmeg, things.
Sure.
Like that.
You know,
nutmeg.
Cinnamon, nutmeg is really good in oatmeal. And I got to tell
yes.
you something else. Oatmeal is not the only hot cereal that you can
cream of wheat.
Eat. There's, well, I'm talking about like the real grain.
Oh.
And so whether it is, what was I going to say? Amaranth. So I don't know if you've heard of amaranth. Okay.
Never. I knew a girl named Amaranth once. She
okay.
lived in Brooklyn.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Interesting name. Interesting name. But it's spelled, in case anyone wants, amaranth. So
A-M-A-M-Y.
You know what? Let me look this
yeah,
up.
Do
I'm
that.
Actually a really good speller, but I don't want anyone saying, oh, she missed a letter. So let me see.
Yeah. Amaranth. Nice lady from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Amaranth.
And what did you learn about her? The nice lady from Brooklyn.
She ate
amaranth.
Healthy stuff and
okay,
would
so
always get very annoyed when I would come visit because I'd always bring me some chicken or some wine or something.
Okay, so amaranth. It's spelled A-M-A-R-Y-N-T-H, amaranth.
That's how she spelled her name.
And the only thing that I could tell you is that it will remind you of a couscous, but smaller than couscous.
Okay.
It's actually smaller, and it's a cross between couscous and popcorn. Now, I know that sounds weird because it sort of pops in your mouth when you cook it. And you prepare it like rice. It takes about maybe 25 minutes to cook. Okay, so I would highly suggest maybe making it the night before. But it's delicious. Okay, so it almost looks like cornmeal. That's a good way to put it. It looks like cornmeal. Okay, and then you just you cook it like rice for about 25 minutes, and then you can add your coconut oil or butter if you use butter. But I would coconut oil is what I put in mine. I put nutmeg, as you just mentioned. Cinnamon and a little bit of almond milk. I use silk almond milk, not any other kind of almond milk right now, because the silk original almond milk does not have the carrageenan, which is the sort of preservative. No, carrageenan is a preservative that's present in most milky products.
There's a commercial that's on one of the channels I watch, and they talk about the silk. And when you said silk, it just perked me right up because they specifically said the silk almond, and I think is there a silk cashew as well? I know
they probably
almond.
Do have a cashew milk probably
yeah.
now. They're
and the guy tastes it and he says, "Oh man, this is really good."
Mm-hmm.
I haven't tried it, but
silk is good. But just make sure you get the original because if you get the vanilla chocolate flavor or whatever, it has the carrageenan, C-A-R-A-G-E-E-N-A-N, in it. Carrageenan is basically a preservative that comes from a seaweed, and
it's as healthy as silk. Milk is, they kill it by adding other stuff
carrageenan,
to it.
Right, the preservative carrageenan, which has also been associated with MSG.
Oh, that's silly.
Well, it is, you know.
Why would you
it
do
is.
That?
I don't. Well, it's an emulsifier, so it makes the reason why, so if you want to know the reason why, because the carrageenan makes the milky products, whether it's a yogurt or ice cream yogurt or ice cream or soy or almond milk. It makes it creamy and it keeps it from settling.
What about yogurts?
So that's why they add the carrageenan in it. So are you clear about that, Phil?
Got it. I will get that soy almond milk.
No, not soy almond milk.
Silk.
You said soy almond milk.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Don't confuse the people.
The sister called and said, "Well, soy was no good for it. She stopped using soy."
Yes.
Give me a quick synopsis on yogurts. I see so many different types of yogurts out there. What's the
key to keep in mind is you just don't want candy added to your yogurt, and candy in the form of just the fruits, strawberry on the bottom, the peach on the bottom.
That's not what you want?
No. You just want to stick to plain and add your own plain whole milk yogurt. So not the low fat or the no fat where all the nutrients and the vitamins and the minerals are being stripped away. You want to stick with organic, whole fat, plain yogurt and add your own sweetener. You can add it raw honey. Which is absolutely divine. It's really delicious. It's thicker and less processed and refined than the regular honey from the honey bear that you buy in the store. And it's not heated at such high temperatures as the regular honey, which basically kills all the nutrients.
So on back to the yogurt, commercial, for example, you have the family that goes into the refrigerator and everybody's grabbing two yogurts.
Right.
That's not the yogurt that we want.
No.
Because it's got the fruit in it.
Right.
You don't want
the cheesecake key lime yogurt. You don't want that. You just want the plain yogurt. And trust me, your yogurt will taste better. You add your little stevia, or some people don't like the taste of stevia, and that's fine because I don't always like it either, but it depends on what you use it for.
What's that?
Stevia is a plant-based sugar. So I would say raw honey. You can chop up some bananas. Remember we talking about bananas? Some nuts.
Yeah.
Some slivered almonds.
So in other words,
blueberries.
All those things that are in the packaged yogurt, if you add them yourself, it's a better
absolutely,
product,
because think about it. We want to try to get in at least, 8 to 10. I don't say 5. I say 8 to 10 veggies and fruits a day. So what better way to get those fruits and vegetables in than to choose foods that you love? So if you like yogurt, get your plain yogurt.
Yeah.
You put your handful of berries and nuts and seeds and whatever else you want to put in there. That's your breakfast, right? So then that's a whole serving, maybe even
and
two servings.
Too.
And it's filling. So you want to know, how do I lose weight? How do I eat healthy and enjoy my food? That's how. It's really, really not quite as difficult as people might think. It's really about developing, again, that word craveable. Make your food, crave it. Find a way to make your food enjoyable. We
got
to go back to playing with our food again, making it enjoyable, because you're not going to continue eating healthy. You're not going to continue the practice if you're not enjoying it.
Indeed.
My goal is to get people to love their food, to love it.
Stand by on that note. Right back. The Lord. Final segment coming up. Monifa Ma'at.
Come on.
Our motivator. Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning, my brother Bill. The Lord is blessing me right now.
You sure about that?
Oh, I'm sure.
Ain't no doubt about it.
No doubt about it.
You sure?
I'm still here. I'm talking to you. I sound much better than I did last Thursday.
Yes, you do.
I thank God.
So is that an indication that the Lord is blessing you?
He has blessed me. He woke me up this morning. He's my everything. I talked to you, Sister Tommy, came on this morning.
Yeah.
We went through Bible study together. I mean, you know, Sunday school.
Have you eaten yet?
Praise the Lord. I ate.
And what'd you eat?
What? I ate what Mama used to feed me.
What'd you eat?
I had some grits and eggs.
Now, our sister here going to take tear that apart. Come on, get her. Get her.
Listen.
Get her.
No.
Bless everything that goes in my mouth. I don't care what it is. If it's going to be a frog's leg, I'm going to bless it too.
Amen.
And I don't like frog's legs.
I do. I do.
You know, you said something really important. It is important to bless everything that you eat.
Yeah.
You know, people should not feel any level, any sense of guilt. Whatever you put in your mouth, because guilt is a poison.
That's right.
So, you know, absolutely, sister. Well, you definitely said it. Bless everything that goes into your mouth. What I was also smiling at, because when you said grits and eggs, I said, wow, you know, because of course, you know, that's what I grew up on. And you know what? You want to know a little secret? I still eat it.
But here's
the thing. I do. I love grits and eggs.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, you can have grits and eggs for breakfast. You can have it for lunch. You can have it for dinner. But here's the thing. Here's the difference is that I make sure to use organic eggs,
yes,
not cage free,
yes,
not omega 3,
mm-hmm,
but organic eggs. Right.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that's one change. The second change is, I mean, we know that most of our corn here, you know, in this country is genetically modified.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, at least what I do is, because I do like grits, I get Red Mills, what is it, Bob's Red Mills organic, yellow organic corn grits. So I don't get the white grits, I get the yellow organic corn grits.
I haven't seen that in a while. Around here, you don't catch that.
But you know what? They have it in a lot of stores, including Pioneer.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they should have it if they ordered it, but Pioneer on 129th Street, where I'm going to do the shopping trip. But here's the thing. What I do is I take some kale or spinach or Swiss chard or whatever dark green leafy vegetable I may have on hand. I saute that with a little bit of garlic,
mm-hmm,
and onions. And then and I take a good bunch of it, like a good amount of it. And then I just put that over on top of the grits.
Uh-huh.
So this way you're getting your vegetables in along with your breakfast.
Yes.
Oh, right?
Interesting.
And it's delicious. And you can have put some sardines on the side.
Bill didn't know what John was. I said, oh, no, he didn't. I thought you was talking about Swiss cheese, though.
Oh no, I know.
It's
so
a vegetable,
brother,
honey.
Yes, it's a vegetable. It's
Mommy
raised
us on all of that. We use Swiss chard. We use all of that.
But the key is to use it not just for dinner or not just for, you know, even with your lunch, but you have it for breakfast. Make it a point to eat vegetables with your breakfast. Or you can take the bag of mixed vegetables.
I've done that.
Yeah. And saute and put those on top of your grits. It's delicious.
With some bacon.
All right. Oh, boy. Be quiet.
Every day you find something new, right?
Absolutely.
All right.
And hanging out with Sister Bonifa, see, is going to keep you healthy. And you're going to eat right? Because, see, when I talked about putting that bacon with my grits, and then she's just like, oh, God,
you
know, just killed the whole thing, you know.
Yeah.
With the vegetable part.
I'm asking something else. I noticed that she was saying about the cow's milk. Because you were saying about the butter, right? Yeah, I was talking about the butter.
Yeah.
And he was saying about cow's milk. But goats give milk, too.
Goats is really good. And the reason why goat milk is good is because they're not as susceptible to many of the antibiotics and hormones that we use for cows here.
Cut you off. Got a couple more calls coming. Right. Try to squeeze in. Thank you so much. Good morning. You're on the air.
This Reverend, I got to have some fun with this one. Hanging out with Sister Bonifa, at least I know you're eating right and keep you around.
Oh, thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Him all the time. God bless you.
I know that's right. Bye.
Bye. That's good.
Not a word.
No, it's important.
We want to thank you again for being part of us and part of our 3G Experience family. And you've taught us a lot. And one thing he did say, in between doing feet. He do feet, you know.
Oh, he does feet too?
That's his thing, Phil. He does feet. He do feet.
That's a celebrity foot doctor.
Yeah.
Ah. And every time I think of him, I have to say, I think of Antonio Vargas with the from Starsky and Hutch, because he said that he was his doctor.
Yes.
So
yes,
whenever he calls, I think of Antonio Vargas.
Good, with the goldfish in the shoes. Yeah. Well, he do your feet while the fish is in the shoe.
Oh. Okay. I don't know how you go
but,
do that.
But in any event, though, he did say something that if we listen to you and the advice that you give, we will live healthy, happy, and better lives. And I'm looking at Amsterdam and 125th Street now, and the sun is shining brightly over the Kingdom of Harlem, and we're here. That's going to do it for this edition of the 3G Experience. Sister Monifa, so glad to have you with us again this morning.
Thank you. So
and
glad to be
she'll
here.
Be back on the 16th, the third Thursday. Oh, another one coming. Get quickly. Got 30 seconds on the phone. Guess you're on the air. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Brother Bill, Sister Joseph. Good morning to you and your guests and our beautiful radio family.
Mm-hmm.
And God is awesome all the time. And
thank you.
Everything
time.
I've heard.
I'm glad you're saying that we stopped saying God is good, you see, because we limit God to four letters. Yeah. God is awesome, you see.
Right. Sure. I met this lady in our Jersey with the service. And she said, I don't say God is good. He's awesome.
That's right.
He definitely is.
For sure. All right, my sister, thank you so much.
Okay,
always.
God bless you. Always. Okay.
Here on the 3G Experience, that's going to do it. Stand by for El Tiempo de Dios con Alejandro Cruz Nunez aquí en el WHCR 90.3 FM en Nueva York.
Gusto.
Yeah, con Dios. Con Dios, siempre con
poquito
Dios.
Español, pero mucho.
Dios es el poder de la vida. Dios es el poder de la vida.
Ah,
like that.
Muy bueno.
Yeah, I'm bilingual and trilingual.
Aha.
Yeah, here on the 3G Experience. Oh, God, here, go on, you're on the air. Quickly. Hello, you're on the air. Quickly.
Oh, yes, I'd like to ask about
all right, that's, I don't know. We got a, that's why we got a dump button. All right, so I don't know. Anyway, so thank you. Love you madly. And it's time for what I just said.
Harlem has its own radio station, WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem.